وصحبي. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, my dear children, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. عيد مبارك, تقبل الله منا ومنكم إن شاء الله صالح الأعمال. I'm going to give a summary of the talks I gave during the four Fridays of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 183, chapter 2, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. O you who believe, fasting is prescribed to you as it was prescribed to those before you, that you may learn self-restraint. So by practicing self-restraint, we endeavor to ward off evil, fear Allah, and become righteous. In Islam, we have three types of compulsory fast, namely the fast of the lunar month of Ramadan, which comes 11 days earlier every year, or fasting to fulfill a vow, or fasting as a form of compensation for an error being done. Fasting is from dawn to sunset, no food, no drink, and no fulfillment of any sexual desire. Also to refrain from vain speech and foul language. Fasting of Ramadan is an obligation on every sane, healthy Muslim, male or female, who has attained puberty. It is one of the five pillars of Islam. The Muslim fast is not meant for self-torture, although it is stricter than other fasts. It also provides concessions for special circumstances. In 2016, Nobel Prize for Medicine was given to a Japanese researcher who proved that fasting is good for the body and prevents some illnesses. But why did Allah ordain on us the fast of the month of Ramadan and not any other month? Allah says in verse 185, chapter 2, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. Ramadan is the month in which was sent down the Quran as guide to mankind, also clear signs for guidance and judgment between right and wrong. So every one of you who is present at his home during that month should spend it in fasting. But if anyone is ill or on a journey, the prescribed period should be made up by days later. Allah intends every facility for you. He does not want to put you to difficulties. He wants you to complete the prescribed period and to glorify him in that he has guided you and you may give thanks. So Allah commands us to fast Ramadan because the revelation of the Quran started in one of the last 10 nights of this holy month over 1400 years ago. A night described by Allah in verse 3, chapter 44 as Layla Mubaraka, a blessed night. And in verse 1, chapter 97, as Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, honor, and the glory. Allah states that on this night every year, angels led by Archangel Gabriel descend on our planet with so many blessings from our Lord. Allah says the night of power is better than a thousand months in blessings and reward and spiritual glory. God instructs us to study the Quran and to act upon its moral law, to live a good and pure life, to attain salvation in the hereafter. When Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was asked about his character, she said, كان قرآنا يمشي على الأرض. He was Quran walking on earth. So let us all try, coming out of Ramadan this year, to become also Quran walking on earth. Allah says in verse 21, chapter 59, if you had sent down this Quran on a mountain, you would have seen it humbled and split apart for fear of Allah. Such are the similitudes which we offer people that they may reflect. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. The revelation is so powerful and convincing that even the hard rock splits asunder under it. Will man then be so arrogant as to consider himself superior to it? Or so hard-hearted as not to be affected by its powerful message? The answer is no for unspoiled man. Yes, for man when degraded by sin to be the vilest of creatures. If we realize the spiritual significance of the fast, we shall look upon Ramadan not as a burden, but as a blessing, and shall be duly grateful for the lead given to us in this matter. So what was the first revelation to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? When Allah spoke to Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam, he said to him, إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعَبُدْنِي وَأَقْمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. O Moses, there is no God but me. So only serve me and establish regular prayers for my remembrance. And when Jesus alayhi salatu wa salam delivered the message from the cradle, what did he say? وَأَمَرَنِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيَّا. And Allah commands me to establish regular prayers and give to charity as long as I do live. But when the first revelation came to Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam in the months of Ramadan, Allah said in verses 1 to 5, chapter 96, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Read in the name of your Lord who created. He created man from a leech-like clot of blood. Read, and your Lord is the most bountiful one, who taught by the pen, taught man what he did not know. So the first command, which was revealed over 1400 years ago in the months of Ramadan, was to learn how to read and write, to abolish illiteracy and eradicate ignorance. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم ومسلمة. Seeking knowledge is an obligation on every Muslim male or female. Unfortunately, at least half of the Muslim world are illiterate, maybe more even than half. Immediately following the creation of Adam, Allah taught him the names of everything. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam the names. It was a privilege the angel did not have. Seeking knowledge and reflecting on Allah's creation to help ourselves and serve humanity should be the quest of every Muslim. God teaches us new knowledge at every given moment. During the high medieval period, the Islamic world was at its cultural peak, supplying knowledge and ideas to Europe via Andalusia, Sicily, and the Crusader kingdoms in the Levant. It was Islamic golden age. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was commanded in the Quran to say in verse 114, chapter 20, وَقُلْ رَبِّي زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. My Lord, increase me in knowledge. We should always pray for increase in our knowledge, which can never at any given moment be complete. Constant effort is necessary to keep our knowledge square with the march of time. But we must remember that spiritual knowledge is far above any little cleverness in worldly affairs. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروا إنه غفور. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وآله وصحبه. أما بعد, during this Ramadan, many mosques, churches and synagogues and the institutions as well invited people to have iftar. That's very interesting. The years before, it was only the mosques who opened the doors for taste Ramadan. But this year, many synagogues actually and churches followed what the mosques were doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 13, chapter 49, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu, inna akramakum inda Allahi atqaakum, inna Allaha alimun khabir. O people, O mankind, we have created all of you from a single pair of a male and female and made you into nations and tribes. لِتَعَارَفُوا, to get to know each other, not to look down on each other or exploit each other or despise each other. Surely the most honored of you in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the righteous, not the black, not the white, not the rich, not the poor. Allah has full knowledge and is well acquainted with all things. He is surely all-knowing, all-aware. And remember, when Satan refused to prostrate himself to Adam, and Allah asked him, why you did not listen to my command? Why you did not obey my command? He said, I am better than him. You created me from fire, and you created him from clay. And that was a racist remark. Following that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expelled him from his mercy, and he gave him the title Iblis, and the title Shaitan, and the title Rajim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَا تَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَنْ تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُوا أَوَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ أَفْشُوا السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ رواه مسلم. The Prophet said, I swear by the one who has my soul in his hand, you will not enter paradise until you believe, and you will not believe until you love one another. Shall I inform you of something which, if you do, you will love one another? Promote greetings among yourselves. Promote salam among yourselves. عن عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص أن رجلا سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أي الإسلام خير؟ قال تطعم الطعام وتقرأ السلام على من عرفت ومن لم تعرف. متفق عليه. A man asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, which act in Islam is the best? He replied, to give food and to greet everyone, whether you know or you don't. I don't have to know you to say السلام عليكم. What will happen if I greet you? Allah says in verse 86, chapter 4, وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَسِيبًا. When you are offered a greeting, respond with a better one, or at least return it. Allah takes careful account of all things. عن أبي يوسف عبد الله بن سلام رضي الله عنه قال, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, يا أيها الناس, أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا الأرحام وصلوا والناس نيام تدخلوا الجنة بسلام رواه الترمذي وقال حديث حسن صحيح. The Prophet said, O people, exchange greetings of peace, i.e. say peace on you to one another. Feed people, strengthen the ties of kinship, and be in prayer when others are asleep. You will enter paradise in peace. This initiative of iftar during Ramadan is about getting to know each other, greeting each other, and sharing food with each other. When we all get to know each other, we'll have no fear of each other. And it is these misconceptions in the world which create Islamophobia. We are all the children of Adam and Eve. We are all the brothers and sisters in humanity. May Allah bless you all. And I'm going to stop by reading a very interesting advice from Imam Ibn al-Qayyim. So please listen to it and take it with you home, please. A friend will not literally share your struggles, and a loved one cannot physically take away your pain. And a close one will not stay up the night on your behalf. So look after yourself, protect yourself, nurture yourself, and don't give life's events more than what they are really worth. Know for certain that when you break, no one will heal you except you. And when you are defeated, no one will give you victory except your determination. Your ability to stand up again and carry on is your responsibility. Don't look for yourself worth in the eyes of people. Look for your worth from within your conscience. If your conscience is at peace, then you will ascend high. And if you truly know yourself, then what is said about you won't harm you. Don't carry the worries of this life, because this is for Allah. Don't carry the worries of sustenance, because it's from Allah. And don't carry the anxiety for the future, because it is in the hands of Allah. Carry one thing: how to please Allah. Because if you please Allah, He will please you. He will fulfill you and enrich you. Don't weep from a life that made your heart weep. Just say, "Oh Allah, compensate me with good in this life and the hereafter." Sadness departs with a sajda. Happiness comes with a sincere dua. Allah does not forget the good you do, nor does He forget the good you did to others and the pain you relieved them from. Nor will He forget the eye which was about to cry, but you made it laugh. Live your life with this principle. Be good, even if you don't receive good, not because of others' sake, but because Allah loves those who do good. Allahumma shfina wa afina wa afu anna. اللهم لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين ربنا آتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا رحمن الدنيا والآخرة ورحمهما أنت ترحمنا فارحمنا برحمة تغنينا بها عن رحمة من سواك وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين and many thanks from all our hearts to everyone who supported us during the month of Ramadan, to all the trustees and the volunteers and the people working in this mosque to serve the community and to help everybody to fulfill their religion. May Allah bless you all, inshallah, and we'll see you on Friday, inshallah. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi.